Good morning, dear students. Today we are going to learn a new chapter from your science book, okay, which is Adaptation in Plants, the second chapter. So open your books and see. Introduction. Number 1, types of plant. Number 2, aquatic plants. Number 3, terrestrial plants. So we are going to discuss these three topics in this chapter. Okay? See, what are the types of plants? Aquatic plants and terrestrial plants. These are the two main types of plant. Okay? So see, aquatic plants includes free floating plants, number 1. Number 2, underwater plants. Number 3, fixed plants. Understand? Free floating plants, underwater plants and fixed plants are included in aquatic plants. Okay. Then see, terrestrial plants. Terrestrial plants includes coniferous trees, mangrove trees, evergreen trees, deciduous trees, desert plants, insectivorous plant, plants of grass family. So these are the types of terrestrial plants. Okay. Now turn the page. See types of plant. Plants can be found almost all over the earth. We can see plants everywhere. Right or not? Some can survive in hot deserts while some in cold regions. So, depends on different climatic conditions or environment. Some plants can survive in hot deserts while some in cold regions. Okay? There are some plants that climb up with some support and others that creep on the ground. So we can see some plants which are climbers. Climber means they need support of some other plants that are known as climbers. Okay, and other that creep on the ground. Creep on the ground means they are along the ground. So these are known as creepers. You have already known because you studied in your previous class, right? So see, plants are not only found on land but also in water. So plants are not only found on land, plants are also found in water. Okay? We find a vast variety of plants in different natural surroundings. So there is not only one type of plants, there is a variety of plants in our surrounding. These plants develop special features to adapt themselves to their surroundings. So, according to the environment, the plants in different regions adapt themselves to survive in that environment. Understand? This process is called adaptation. So, underline this sentence. What is adaptation? Some plants develop special features to adapt themselves to their surroundings. This process is called adaptation. So you have to remember this. Next, see, plants are generally found on land or in water. So plants are found in both in land and water. Let us give them a closer look and understand them better. So we are going to learn about aquatic plants and terrestrial plants. Okay, we can divide plants in mainly two types. There are two types of plants. What are they? Number 1 is aquatic plants, number 2 is terrestrial plants. Okay? Aquatic plants. Plants that grow in water are called aquatic plants. So, what is aquatic plants? The plants that grow in water are known as aquatic plants. In the water, we see various types of aquatic plants. So, there is not only one type of plant in water. We can see various types of aquatic plants. Okay, they adapt themselves to make their food in water. So, in the water, they have to adapt themselves to make their food. Aquatic plants are of three types. There are three types of aquatic plants. So see, free floating plants. One type is free floating plants. Their roots are not attached to the soil. The roots of free floating plants are not attached to the soil. They float in water. Okay, they are very light and spongy and floats on the surface of water. The free floating plants are very light and spongy. Because of this nature, free floating plants floats on the surface of water. They are floating on the surface of water. Some common examples of free floating plants are water hyacinth, water lettuce, duckweed, etc. So these are the examples of free floating plants. Understand? These plants use sunlight and carbon dioxide from the air to make food. So they prepare their food by the process of photosynthesis. Because of this, they use sunlight from the sun and carbon dioxide from the air. Okay? They protect small water animals from the hot sun. Because free floating plants floats on the surface of water, so they can protect small water animals from the hot sun. Okay, they protect the small water animals from the heat of sun. See, underwater plants. These are the plants that grow under the surface of water. So the plants that are grow under the surface of water are known as underwater plants. Their roots are fixed to the soil or to the bottom of shallow ponds and rivers. Their roots are fixed to the soil. In case of free floating plants, what do you got? The roots of free floating plants are not attached to the soil. Yes or no? But in case of underwater plants, the roots are fixed to the soil. This is the difference. You have to study thoroughly. Okay? Some common examples are pondweed, tap grass, etc. So these two are examples of underwater plants. They are long, ribbon-like, narrow leaves, have no stomata at all. So the leaves of underwater plants have no stomata. Stomata are absent in underwater plants. Okay? These plants breathe through their body surface. Because of lack of stomata, the plants breathe through their body surface. These plants clean the water by removing carbon dioxide breathed out by the aquatic plants. So, how can these underwater plants clean the water? These plants clean the water by removing carbon dioxide breathed out by the aquatic plants. These plants remove carbon dioxide from the water. Okay. We put such plants in an aquarium to increase the oxygen level and act as a food for the fish. Because of its beneficial characteristic that it can remove carbon dioxide from the water. So, because of that, we put underwater plants into the aquarium to increase the oxygen level. And these plants are also act as food for the fish. Okay? See, next page, fixed plants. These plants have their roots fixed to the bottom of the pond. So, the roots of fixed plants fixed to the bottom of the pond. Some common examples of fixed plants are lotus, water lily, etc. So these are the examples of fixed plants. Their long hollow stem supports the large leaves and flowers that floats on the surface of the water. So fixed plants have large leaves. So these leaves are supported by hollow stem. Okay, these plants have stomata only on the upper surface so that water doesn't block the pores. These plants have stomata where? On the upper surface. Big. So that water does not block the pores. Okay. The broad leaves of such plants provide a nesting place for some teeny birds or tiny birds. So the fixed plants have large or broad leaves. So these leaves provide nesting place for tiny birds. Understand? So students, hope you all understand this. So you read the portion we have learned today and send me your audio. Okay, thank you. Have a good day.